The broadcast is now starting. All attendees are in listen-only mode.
So good evening to all of you. Hi Mahesh, hi Ganesh, hi Birjin. So we are here to, I'm here to present the back channel and informal assessment online tools generally used in classroom for the students. And so coming to a few basic things, and we are broadcasting this from GoToWebinar, and it's a versatile feature, better than Skype and Hangouts. So it's a good web conference and web meeting tool. Yeah, it's not free, it's paid. The whole recording, whole webinar session is recorded automatically, and this webinar will be most interactive, and majorityly I don't show any much slides here. We directly interact with what you access through your browsers. And thank you for joining me in this large session. So over the next 45 to hour, we will look at various tools which helps for the back channel informal assessment, widely used in the classroom. It's not grading the students. It's a kind of comprehensive identification regarding your concepts which was understood by your students, and it is a kind of a survey or a feedback. And we will give in the form of a start students, in the form of a short quizzes, and allow the students to give us some informal feedback by using surveys as well as short quiz and one-to-one interaction on the conference. So you need to open two browsers actually, because one you can act as a, in one browser you can access as a simultaneously a teacher, and in another browser you can access as a student. So to view both the versions you need two different browsers. It's better to understand, open two different browsers. And today I just we take a look at those four important tools which generally most of the people use it for a kind of back channel assessments. So the tools basically which are used for this assessment, which is a kind of an informal assessment, and one is Today's Meet, and the one is Padlet. Maybe the screencast is a bit low due to the connectivity. So the second one is Today's Meet, and the first one is Today's Meet, the second one is Padlet, and third one is Kahoot, and the fourth one is, it's a Socrative, which is in general, all these are used as a informal back channel tools. And we'll just first look into that. I don't show any more kind of what we call slides. I just directly interact with you in the browsers. So today we'll see the first back channel tool, which is one of the majority people used a tool which we call it as a Today's Meet. So Today's Meet in general, it's a very easy setup, easy to set up. It is a free one. Either you can log in, or otherwise without even sign in also you can access the features. If you are the member, teacher member of this Today's Meet, you will be given some privilege of usage of special teacher tools which are exclusively free. for the teacher only. And one more thing is, when we are using this, I just give an introduction regarding today's meet. So today's meet is the premier back channel chat platform for the classroom teachers as well as the students and leaders. It's a free tool, easy to set up, one-to-one environment, meet in real-time environment for the conversation. Room was in general. So when we look into the, see, you can keep the room open in general for 1 hour, 2 hours, 8 hours, 1 day, 1 week, or 1 month. Even if you are paid, you can keep it for 1 year also. So after defining your room to be open, so it is a self-destructive room. Generally, automatically, after the completion of the stipulated time period, it automatically destroys. It's a self-destructive. And one of the important features of this today's meet is you can use this as a back channel. Suppose if you want to interact with your students by a conversation, so related to that you create a room. So creating a room, we'll do how a room can be created. So this is, of course, in general, what we can say, the main feature which we can say is definitely by creating a room, please bear with us, there is a connectivity problem, still audio is connecting once again. Is it okay? Is it audible? Anybody is having any doubt, please. Hi Virgin, welcome to evening session. And here, so when we look into this, so I'm very keenly working on these back channel tools. So what we need to do is, yeah, welcome back to attendees. So we'll look into the today's meet, which is used commonly as a back channel tool. So basically, if you start a conversation regarding a particular point, what you need to is, you wanted to interact with your students by making use of this today's meet. It's a self-destructive. I'm just creating it is for 1 hour. Right now I'm creating it for 1 hour. So in this 1 hour, what happens? The interactive will be lively available. And before that, what you need to do is you have to give a room name to your room, that by saying that Raghu. So I have just given a name called Raghu. Now I am opening a room by name Raghu for a 1 month. So not is name, the name is not valid because it is already created with that. Raghu 123, I will say. So now it has accepted. See, the room has opened with the name of Raghu 123. But what you need to do is, you need to nickname this back channel. Is my topic. That's why I created with a back channel. And just know what I wanted to just do is, I just send messages. So if you want to just interact with me in this today's meet, you just copy this URL, that is todaysmeet.com/raghu123, and open in your browser and start typing messages. Say hello to the group. So I just typed and I posted in this, what do you teach? If not, what do you study for students? I hope in some of this group we have students also. My students also are involving in this. Please, you copy this. So you can access by clicking this URL, and in that you can also start conversation, because students also copy this and they will open in the browser and they start conversation with the teacher by using a topic. So like this, you can keep conversation with these people and you can do whatever you like. I'm asking that some of you, please, what do? You just copy this URL. Koila, welcome to the evening webinar. So you just copy this URL. Copy this URL. And after copying, you open in another browser. Another browser, and you just, thank you, Ganesh. So like this, we can start conversation on a particular topic. And what do I normally do in the classroom? So these are the some of the tools which are really used consistently for our students to know the feedback from the students. So what do? I just showcase a video. A YouTube video I will showcase, and simultaneously I'll ask the students to interact with your computer by opening today's meet for the conversation. Is it clear? So when I start doing this, what they do mean, I'll ask the children to go through the video and find out what are the questions normally you will get in your mind after watching this video or while watching the video. Please post your questions by using today's meet. So we'll open for one for everything. So in this session we do in a such a way. So what happens? There is a clear-cut interaction between the student to student. We can enhance the discussion. So rather than I give questions and I directly give the questions on that particular video, so I'll ask the children, go through the video and post your questions, what you felt in your mind. So in that way, what happens, normally there is a clear-cut discussion for the answering setup. Then what happens, there is a conversation process which starts. This is one of the good tool I feel, and it is very easy tool. Every teacher can use this for the back channel purposes, and simultaneously it is a good tool where normally you can keep this row open for either a one or two, so that the continuity discussion can be keep recorded and that can be viewed by the students and the teachers. If you invite even other colleagues of other teachers related to your subject, and it becomes more lively and discussion will be fruitful and the children will enjoy the discussion and they learn by conversing, while they will express very freely their thoughts as well as their expressions. So now what we can do, other features which are there here. Now normally if you go to room tools, so there are different kinds of things. So you can create a QR code and you can show it in the projector view, and even you can embed this in any kind of, what we can say that you can embed this in blog, you can embed this in the WordPress. And what I just wanted to showcase is, if you want to just examine the various conversation which was happened in the later part, that can be also done by using transcript. So transcript is a feature which allows you to print, it can see all these, whatever the conversation are there, they will be showcased in the timely order. And even then, if you want a hard copy, that you can make it as a print by clicking, that you can save this in the form of PDF. So you can see all the conversations which are happening in the room, who has, what has done, who has done. So everything can be seen here. So according to the chronicle time order, you will see all the comments which are done by the students. So in this way, what happens, you can save it and you can give it a hard copy to your students so that they can look into all the conversation, what happened regarding that. So this is one of the good thing that we can do. But the thing is that the bad with this is, in the sense, normally when we are dealing with younger children, so you need to take care, because it is not a securely high one, because it doesn't give much security. This is open to everybody. So due to this, what happens, anybody can, because this URL, by using this URL, anybody can access and they can comment on it. So that's why it is better, when we are using, you must use it in a wise way. So you need to just emphasize more those students and teachers which are normally should be used in ethical way. So the thing is that, as I mentioned, it is to open to everybody, and simultaneously it is a self-destructive. After completion of the stipulated time which we have chosen in that list, it, the room is live till that time period, and after that automatically it is a self-destructive method. So you can create as many as rooms you can. If you just sign in, your rooms will be stored. The previous history of rooms can be seen, at least when you are signed in and become a member. So if you are not signed in, so those rooms which are created by you, they will not be stored. So that is a normal methodology. If you take out the transcript by PDF view or print, that would be very nice, that it can be keep a record. So this is regarding the one of the tool which I wanted to share, that is today's meet. So after this, I just wanted to focus on other one, so which is also a very important bit, security wise helps the student, and it can be done in a protective environment. So that is, in general, we call it as Padlet. So Padlet is a kind of virtual wall, what I can say. It's a canvas wall on which normally you can share the notes, you can share the questions, you can share your opinion, you can include your multimedia elements like picture, video, and you can even, you can share the documents which you want. So all that can be done, which cannot be seen in the today's meet. So today's meet is a purely textual conversation where you need to just only type the text. But Padlet is a virtual wall that allows the people express their thoughts on a common topic easily. It works like a online sheet of paper. So it's generally with you. It works like an online sheet of paper. It works like an online sheet of paper. So this sheet of paper generally can be used. Maybe there will be some disturbance of audio. I'm just again repeating. The Padlet is works like an online sheet of paper where people can put content, images, videos, documents, etc. Anywhere on the page together with anyone from any division. Means you can device, in the sense the Padlet you can access from an iPod, you can iPhone, Android phone, Windows phone, laptop, desktop, any sort of software supports this Padlet. So generally we let's look into one of the all of the Padlet that what we can create. Just type padlet.com. So the moment you open, so it creates a kind of wall. I think the Padlet dot allows to emphasize more interaction between the teachers and students, and you can work on a common platform. The thing is, what you can do is, so this is a Padlet, because already I have username and password. I am a member of this Padlet.com. So it showcases all those which are earlier used Padlets in my dashboard. So this is the dashboard which is saying different kinds of things. So here, looking into this, you can create a new wall. So here I just wanted to open a new Padlet wall. So click on the new Padlet wall, and so the moment you click on it, so it opens a white canvas on which whatever you want to keep, whatever you want to comment. So you can comment by just clicking double click on the canvas. So the moment you double click, it opens a small window. You just Raghu. Hi everyone, hope you are following the session. So I just step. So now this become a sticky note, and this sticky note you can just put it anywhere. So if you want to access this, please copy this. And before I just say, I just wanted to do some corrections. This is the one which normally we call it settings. In this, what I wanted to just say, if you want, this is the basic information. So here, if you see padlet.com/raghubloom/rw blah 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 blah, this means the URL is not familiar and it is very difficult to remember. So that's why instead of that, I just put Raghu, the title to this, and description means a sample virtual wall. So this is the difference. So this is a plain one. I just wanted to share, means if you want to add any kind of photographs to this, you can add photo. And similarly, if you want to keep any wallpaper, that wallpaper also can be added. So you choose the wallpaper among these, and that wallpaper can be, I just chose blue one. So this allows to change your even canvas colors, which allows you to make it more attractive. So now what I do right now, I just wanted to change this URL. This URL is not friendly, so people cannot remember this. So what I do, I just change this URL by just clicking this is what I am seeing. It is a Raghu Bloom user, and now I'm just going to change this by clicking here. And here, coming to the address, I'm just clicking on address. So this is the one default address which is generated by Padlet. Now I just don't want this, and I just want something else. So pick a padlet.com address like Here I will put sample. So sample is available, it has said. Now I am clicking on it. So the moment I click here, so you can see that there is a change in the URL here. Now what you need to do is, I am just requesting all of you, just copy this in your browser and open the Padlet page and post something on this wall so that there is an interaction. So all of you please share something on this. If you want to delete, you can click on it. So the moment you go, if you want to edit, you can click here. If you want to delete, you can clicking on this dustbin, you can. So thank you Ganesh for your feedback. So I just ask the rest of the attendees also, please post something, whether it is useful or not useful, please do it. And now coming to them, some more additional features. What I can say, by default, this URL, this your virtual wall is not open to everybody. If you just search with this URL in your Google search or Yahoo search or Bing search, you don't get it. Because by default, the address what you have here, so when you go to privacy, see here, you can see by default it shows has a hidden link. This is a hidden link. If you want to just make it as a public, you can make it public by just clicking totally public. So after making public, you can get this virtual wall URL. It can be searched in Google as well as Bing as well as in Yahoo. And you can also assign rights. So you can assign rights to the people by only you can write giving a viewing, and you can also giving the right by writing also. So by default it is a hidden link, and we have given a right, can view, can write, can be moderate. So that's why we can give, can write, and after changing it, you can submit this. And here also, along with that also, you can invite the people by just using the emails. And even that, you can exclusively make it this wall to be accessed to only your students by giving password protected. So if you just click on the password protected and you give 1, 2, 3, 4 or something, and which is known to your students, and those only they can access this virtual wall and they can comment on this. By this way, we have a bit of security where normally that cannot be seen in the today's meet. Thank you Mahesh for your feedback. I think you are following. Hope you, it may not be useful for you, but certainly it can be used for different purposes also, but it's energy, means some knowledge enriching sessions that you can benefit something from this session. And thank you for joining with me in this evening, and I'll just make it as a hidden only. So like this, we have different, I'll just type different types of things here. So here, what another feature what we just wanted to say, show you is the layout. If you click layout, the layout which you see, it is a free form layout. So it can be made in the form of a grid, it can be made in the form of a tag stream. By clicking that, you can see all are generally, the latest will be at the top and the oldest will be at the bottom, that you can rearrange all these things according to your wish, which is means if the students have posted different comments on particular conversation, so which is more reliable and which is more related to that topic, you can make it at the top. And gradually the unrelated one and far related one, you can make it in a different way. So that is, you can make it in a stream way, you can keep it in a grid way, or similarly you can keep it in a free form way, wherever it is haphazardly distributed throughout the world. So by this way, normally you can do this also. And one more thing is that because everybody cannot open the URL, you are a student, you cannot say every time that open this URL and do and comment on it, virtual wall, and into doing such activity means repeatedly, I suggest that you embed this wall in your blog or WordPress, where normally you interact with your students. Like we have a classroom subject blogs, classroom means class blogs. In such kind of blogs, you can embed this wall. That generally, I will show you that here, when we just look into that, there is a command called share. So in this, you can share this, click on it. So here, the moment you click, you are able to see the embed code. The embed code very clearly given. These are the two codes. If you want access through mobile, you just use this IR code. So here is the a code for the blogs, those who want to embed in the blog, and this is the code for the WordPress, those who want to embed in the WordPress. So now right now I just wanted to embed this in my blog. So Control C, go to my blog, click edit. Now the moment it opens, what you need to do is just after opening this, what you need to do is you can directly copy and paste it, or otherwise instead of doing this also, we can go to HTML tag, given enter here, and in between these two coding tags you just paste it. After pasting, you give some title to this page by this post, virtual wall. So I just gave this title, and after that you publish. The moment you publish, what happens, the code which is embedded here will showcase. It showcases. And now what you need to do is view this in the blog. The moment after embedding the code, if you open your blog, so then what happens? Actually, it is taking a bit time because there is a problem with connectivity. See, yeah, it has come. So you can see this one here, and here right now you can start a discussion. So double click here, type something and ask your students to do something. So means wherever you are doing in the Padlet, whatever you are doing in the Padlet, the same can be done here also. But just this facilitates the students, because students are familiar with your blog, so they can visit frequently your blog. While they are visiting, they can post the comment related to that conversation on your virtual wall. So the similarly, you can embed your virtual wall in the WordPress as well as blog also. This is how normally we can embed the code of this Padlet in your blog. So normally, what additional that we can do along with this also, I just wanted to share some more features. Here there is a chance of embedding an image or embedding any kind of thing. See, this is, click here, it asks you to upload or you web link or take a photo. So I just wanted to choose a file which now I wanted to upload. Just I wanted to upload a jingle bell. So the moment if you, so it takes it, the time take normally depends upon the speed of the internet. So hopefully if you just take a small size, it takes minimum 30 to 40 seconds to upload. So this is the image which I wanted to, okay. So the moment you just embed, that means attached, you would see in that sticky note. So means which is not possible with the today's meet, that can be possible with this. So in this way, what you can do is right now you can create such kind of things. You can upload. Now I just wanted to upload any video. So do you have any knowledge of any video, any kind of document if you want to do is that you can be do. Good. So I just wanted to open a YouTube. So meanwhile the YouTube will open. So you select anything. I just wanted to jukebox AR Rahman. So copy this URL. Copy this URL and just post here and submit. So normally that link, generally if you click OK, so that is why normally what we can see, so the moment you see, you can see AR Rahman's the jukebox which was I embedded. So that thing can be seen on this wall. So the moment it upload, you just click OK. So then what happens, within a short period of time, that you can see your sticky note will have the jukebox of AR Rahman. So means what I just wanted to say, you can embed or you can add multimedia elements like images, audio, video. In addition that, you can also add different types of documents on this wall. It can be shared. So it has more versatility, more security, more protective, more accessible, and more elements can be embedded along with your voice. Means in the sense, whatever you are typing in your opinion during this posting of this, you along with that, you can also suggest the students that go through this video and observe this vision, and everything can be also given in this fashion. So this is how normally we can say, this is another important back channel tool which helps in the informal assessment. And after this, I just wanted to suggest you another important tool which I oftenly use for this, what kind of, for the students, that is in general, I can show you that is the third tool which can be used. It's a kind of game based quiz and that can be conducted lively, and that one is Kahoot. Generally, we have two versions of Kahoot. The Kahoot teacher version is different and the Kahoot student version is different. Both are two different types of versions. Generally, the teacher wanted to create any kind of quizzes, game-based quizzes. They need to log into getkahoot.com. If not, the students want to access this, they have to log into kahoot.it. So these are the two different URLs which normally allows you to create the videos based quiz or simultaneously to create to access those quizzes. So normally I just show you how to create a quiz by using Kahoot. So here, once you log in kahoot.getkahoot.com, so you will be seeing this kind of dashboard. So this dashboard allows you to create a kind of environment that hopefully, the main purpose of Kahoot is, a Kahoot is a collection of questions on specific topic created by teacher as well as student, and they are asked in real time. It's a real time environment based quiz, not like offline or online after that. So the teacher will be on one browser as accessing the teacher one, and the student will be attending simultaneously, and whatever the student they are doing, the teacher can lively observe those things. So just we will make a a quiz based on that. Normally we can see how this can be, because after making a quiz, it generates a code. That code has to be put to access the quiz. So all those things we'll see. You can access it can be accessed by unlimited number, and unlimited players can be accessed at the same time. And it's a kind of creating a social fun and game like environment based learning. That is, children can enjoy this kind of quiz. So what I do, I just make a quiz. To create a new quiz, click on the quiz. So now after clicking on that, you will be getting, let us start by giving the name of the quiz. So what we do, we'll give a name like back channel. I just click here after giving back channel, and it has opened another page. So another page, in the sense, it allows you to create questions. So now what I do, I just create, it's like a, I will choose a image first of all. I'm just choosing this, and based on that, what kind of image is this? What kind of image is this? Now what I do, I just, here what you can do, you can assign question points to the answer. So here there are two options. If you want to award points, you keep this. If you don't want to award the points, you just no points questions. So just I am wanted to award the marks to the question. So the time limit for the answering the question also you can assign here, 5 seconds, 10 seconds, 30 seconds, according to the ability of the learner. That we can make it as a beginner, intermediate and advanced version. So now I'm giving 60 seconds because it's for the beginner. So I just wanted to just you, this is a bell, golden bell, jingle bell, none of the above. So I just gave four options, and here what you need to is, you just have to assign which is correct answer. I'm just giving this is a correct answer. So now after creating one, add another question. To add another question, click here. So the moment you click, another question is added to this. So Kahoot is generally is a high is back channel server based one. Normally it becomes very slow where normally the connection is very slow. So that what you need to is you just use very very low loaded images or videos, whatever it may be, and we'll just upload another file. I wanted to just upload a very small file which is not much load. So here whatever I see there are, this is a bit, this is a very very big one, and this is also a bigger one, and this is of course 200 KB. I'm just uploading this because it is a bigger one, it is taking time. What occasion we use this card? On what occasion we use this card? Birthday, death day, annual day, in for hospitalized friend. So for hospitalized friend, so I just give, and I just this one gave as a second one. So I have made two questions which are image based. So what I do now, I just wanted to finalize this quiz by clicking save. Now we have two questions. The question quiz name is back channel. If you want to edit, edit. The first one given 60 seconds. The second one is given 20 seconds and consists of four multiple choice. And now click. I'm clicking again, save and continue. So in this aspect, I'm just clicking on save and continue. So here, the moment you click, it asks some of the features which has to be targeted for the people. So should I make it for the public or private? Should I use it for the school, university, business, training, whatever it may, I've been choosing choose. Say just sample. And it should, here you in the description, you should write what is the actual purpose of creating this quiz. And you can make it as a beginner, you can make it as intermediate, you can make it as advanced, but just dragging this, and now I make it as a beginner one. So if you want to put any tags, you can put tags. If not, save, continue. So lastly, what you need to do is after save, continue, you click, it comes that done. So here in the bottom, you click done. So the moment you have completed, your creation of is there. Now you are ready. This quiz is ready to ready for play, and you can ask the student to access. But to act to make access to your students, what you need to use, first click on the play. So it creates a kind of coding language, so it allows you to access. So in this juncture, what happens, it gives some details of those things. And now what you will do, we'll launch the quiz. So the moment you launch the quiz, it just displays that people are ready for the quiz or not. And here it displays two important points. One, what you need to note down is where to join this quiz, and it displays the URL. See where to join the quiz. I'm requesting all of you, please open Kahoot.it. Kahoot.it in another browser, and you just after that you put this a game pin. So enter with game pin, so that what happened, you can access to that particular quiz. So now what happens, the moment you just put the game pin and enter, so it displays like this, where you need to enter the game pin. If you enter, the moment you enter the game pin here, what happens, I can see the players who joined this quiz here. Now right now the players are zero here, the players are zero here. So if you want to involve in this, see, I have seen Prakul, GK are generally has joined, the three players have joined, and Ganesh is also joined. I'm just asking few more to access this. Right now we have four players to access this game based quiz. And after that, what happens, the moment I think that all the people have joined, I just click start. The moment I click start, now it will be access to the people, and two questions are ready. And the moment the questions are ready, it displays. So it, hope this quiz is access to all the four people. So what you need to is, you need to answer within a stipulated period. So far there is zero answers I got. So what I need to do is, I'm just waiting for the people to answer this. One answer has got, because one of the student has answered the question. So the time's up now. Jingle bell is the correct answer, and someone has opted none of the above, maybe. So the first round is over, means first quiz results have been declared. Only one student have answered the question. I'll go to the second one. See, none of you have scored because MK has opted the none of the above. And coming to the second question, in the second question, it shows that get well soon card. When we use this get well soon card, so two answers have come. So three answers have come, and one is death day they have shown, and another two are birthday as shown. So these are the two questions which normally answered by the quizzes. Means you are able to answer the question in a live environment where the teacher is able to see all those things which are happening in the live environment. And if you can see GK, which normally got 899 points, and MK got 571. So these are the things normally based on the priority basis and the near to the correction. Normally the automatically the Kahoot will answer, will provide the questions. So this is how normally we can see. And the feedback can also be given by the student by clicking the feedback and the results. So we can see the people can give, it's like a fun or learning or recommended or feeling. What is your feeling regarding this? You can opt, you can give a rating to this quiz. You can just express your feeling. Somebody has expressed their feeling, and somebody has given different kinds of feeling. So they have expressed their feeling. At least thanks, most of the people are able to access the quiz, those who were there. So in this way, normally you can make use of Kahoot like a game-based learning, and we have seen this here. So if you want to click the final results, so click on the final result, and these results can be downloadable, and that can be stored even in the Google Drive, and you can make use of this differently. So the sheet of the results can be printed out, and you can store it in the form of PDF, whatever it may be. So that is how normally we use Kahoot for the game-based learning. So this is one of the advantage what we can see. Every feedback what we get, the moment we'll get at the same moment. So that is how normally we can make use of these things, and like we can create a healthy environment and a game-based environment during the live environment. This cannot be use it for the grading purpose, that you just use it as a back channel tool for identifying the comprehension of your students. It's better to do that. And this is how normally the Kahoot is there. And along with that, I just wanted to make you to introduce another tool which is very, very useful. That one I just is another one is called Socrative. Socrative also similarly is a smart student response system. Actually, you can visualize the understanding of the student based on the quiz. It's a smart student responsive system that empowers teachers to collect the data from their students via different devices, because this Socrative is enabled. You can use it in laptop, you can use it in desktop, you can use by the smarts, and you can use it through this iPhone, iOS, you can use through the Android, you can use through window phone, and it can be accessed. But here, the moment you see here, it has two options. And these two options in general, what I can say, the teacher will use this teacher tab, and the students will use through student tab. So we'll just see how we can create, because this is as similar as Kahoot also, but it has a different feature also. We'll see first how a teacher can make use of this quiz. And just go to Socrative, click the teacher one. So the moment you click, you can right now you can sign in by just creating, or otherwise you can use a Google account. I'm using my Google account to access this Socrative, and it is a kind of phenomenon. Now I just wanted to use my account, the Google account. I'm accessing through the Google account, and the moment you entered, showcases some of the versions which are normally seen in the system. See, if you just look into the menu which are here, one is dashboard. It allows you to create different types of quizzes, and if you have already created quizzes, you can just click on the manage quizzes, and you can create new quizzes, you can upload, you can import any quiz, you can just already created quizzes can be seen in the My Quiz. And once the student access the quiz, you can just look into the live results of those quiz. So my request is everybody, see, they log in as a student, and what they do, this is the code for the room entry. So the entry code into the Socrative quiz is WWQSNKZW. So that is a case sensitive, so you need to use all the capitals. Now what I wanted to do, I just wanted to create a new quiz. So click on creating new quiz. Now what kind of question you wanted to add? Now name of the quiz, sample A, B, C. This is the title of the quiz what I just used. Now I just wanted to make a multiple choice question. It's a purely multiple choice. I'm just, how do you feel about this webinar? So this is my question, and I just wanted to give very good, informative, average, bad, need improvement. So these are the five different options I have given to multiple choice question. Then after that, what you need to do, you just here I have given a multi set answer question, but answer is, I just giving, this is my answer. So the answer to this webinar is very good. So if you click on very good only, you are able to get correct answer. So now, well done. If it is that, well done. Now I just wanted to ask another question, that is true or false. Is this is useful for you? So now what you need to do is, you have to click either true or false, yes or no. Again, I'm clicking describe about you. So now what I need to do is, I need to save this. Now all three are ready. Save and exit. The quiz is saved now. Now what I need to do is, I have to start a quiz. Now what is, I just wanted to click the recent one which is made just now. I'm just clicking on it. Now the moment is, so I just wanted to give, there are three options. It is a student immediate feedback, or if student based student navigation, or teacher paste. I just wanted to give as a student paste. And now disable student. These are all the options which normally you can give it or not. I just keep it as it is and I just click start and I am confirming this. Please all of you note down, this is the one WWQSN, that is the code you need to use for that quiz. I'm clicking please confirming, and now I can see if people are accessing my quiz with this code, they're able to come here. So people, please enter the quiz by with this code number and attend all the three questions so that you can see your responses on this screen. So please B dot, yeah, Ganesh has already has logged in and I'm asked, he is answering the first one and I'm requesting the other attendees, please log into that and attend the quiz. So which normally when we click on live results, you are able to see at what extent the student has attended the quiz and how many quizzes he has attended, and according to that normally you can also get a feedback from them. So in this juncture, so this is a kind of live feedback information which we can readily can obtain from the student. Hoping that most of you are all enjoyed this because it has already beyond the time limit, and I say Prapul have joined also in this session. And to so after completion of all your students, you make it still, you make it this quiz live, and once they have attended and they have completed this quiz, you can just click finish. By clicking on finish, it stops the process of what we can say the attending of quiz. So I just stopping the quiz. Sahib, welcome to Chaudhary ji. Chaudhary, you have also logged in and I just want you to finish all the three questions. Yeah. And GK, thank you for joining the quiz. Hope everybody has understood the potentiality of these live session quizzes, and I hope that by tomorrow morning the recording session is also available on Technology for Teachers FB. The URL will be posted over there. So now what I do, I just stop finishing the quiz. Yes, so now the quiz is stopped and no more can access this quiz. And these reports, you can see it can generate the report. So that report can be downloaded. It can also send to individuals, question specific and or Excel format, and you click download. So the moment you click, so those corresponding files will be downloaded, and those you can just go ahead. See here, you are able to see the Socrative one, it has a RAR file. So if you click on the PDF will open, and if you click on the Excel, it shows the different answers which are scored by the, means opted by the students. Now this is how normally, it has additional features also, but I don't have time that you can use these, explore these options, the Space Race. The Space Race is a kind of tool that what happened, what we can see, this is how normally it, you can see whatever you have filled. Bala Sahib, sir, they were very good. See all these things that normally you can get in the form of Excel sheet. Similarly, you can also see your Socrative quiz. So with options like these things. that is how normally you can get a printout of all these things and you can keep it for your record for the assessment or identification of comprehensive assessment given by the student. And here also you can explore all this. And this is like space race is kind of a quiz which is normally conducted in the form of a group. So we allow the students in the form of a group, and these groups will be assigned, and based on that, the group student, the students which are involved in the group, they will attend this, and that we will, anybody can be, I think you, most of you can do it also by just taking their space race. It doesn't mean it gives a kind of what we can say like a game based assessment, what we can say. I can say well, game based kind of thing. We just even also look into that also. So actually these are the four important tools. Now I ask you select a quiz, sample ABC, number of teams. I'm just giving two numbers. Auto assign teams, rocket, yes, I say rocket, and start. So here I have given two teams. So means these rockets will move forward depending upon the answering of the question by the teams. Clear? So means what happens, the student has to opt either the blue or magenta team. So by opting that, when he enters and he answers the question, depending upon the accuracy of that answer, you will see the movement of these rockets. Attendees, if you just answer, those things will move. Otherwise, normally they'll be in the same place only. So hope this you have understood. See, you have seen one blue was moved forward, and you have seen it was completed very fastly. Like normally, we can see this kind of funny things which can be included. You can have a rocket, you can have a bicycle, you can have a motorbike over there also. So by this, normally it's a kind of a creating a funness, fun based learning, and online live results can be obtained. This I just click finish, and if you want to generate reports, you want to view chart, anything can be done. So then click report or exit, and you will be coming to the dashboard. And hope you have enjoyed this this session. If you have any queries, please don't hesitate to write to my email ID raghubloom@gmail.com. hope you people have enjoyed this quiz and enjoyed these four back channel generally what we informal assessment tools which are normally used for student feedback surveys and attachment. Thank you for the joining in this evening. Have a great day. Thank you.